तो આપણે એરિયા કઈ રીતે ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ કરવાનું છે એ જોઈએ. પહેલો એક્ઝામ્પલ યુઝિંગ મેથડ ઓફ ઇન્ટિગ્રેશન. Using method of integration, find the area bounded by the curve mod x plus mod y equal to 1. So let us discuss solution. So mod x plus mod y equal to 1, it represents four lines. How? When we remove the modulus, we have to take plus minus. So from mod x plus mod y equal to 1, when we remove modulus, we will get two equation, mod x plus y equal to 1 and mod x minus y equal to 1. Mod y equal to plus minus y according to y greater than 0 or y less than 0. And for mod x, again when we remove the modulus, we will get two lines. So totally there will be four lines. Here when we remove modulus, mod x equal to x plus y equal to 1 or minus x plus y equal to 1. So we have used this formula, mod x equal to plus minus x. Similarly here, x minus y equal to 1 or minus x minus y equal to 1. So replace mod x equal to plus minus x. So from this, here when we take minus common, this line actually it is x plus y minus 1 equal to 0. Here if we remove minus sign, then x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Take minus common, so x minus y equal to minus 1, so that x minus y plus 1. Similarly here, x minus 1 minus x minus y minus 1 equal to 0, and here x plus y plus 1 equal to 0. So total you can observe there are four lines. Now we know the basic principle, if two lines are parallel then constant terms are different. So if we denote these four lines by say 1, this is 2, second line, third line and fourth line. Now two lines are parallel, then constant term is different. So first and fourth, you can observe first and fourth lines are parallel because only constant term is different. Similarly, second and third line are parallel because constant terms are different. So when we draw the lines, there may be a shape of this form. So this is x axis, y axis, year 1, 0, this is 0, 1. So this is the line x plus y equal to 1. Here -1, 0, 0, -1. So fourth line, it is x plus y. This is the line x plus y equal to -1. First and fourth line are parallel. Now you can observe bounded region. It consists of four equal portion, alpha, beta, gamma and delta. So it is enough to find area of alpha, and then total area will be 4 into alpha. Now for alpha, here limit is 0, 0. Y as a function of x in this equation, y equal to 1 minus x from the equation of x plus y equal to 1. So now let us find area of portion alpha. So we will find area of alpha, then we multiplied it by 4, so we will get total area. This portion is alpha. So for alpha, A equal to mod I according to this formula, A to B y dx. Limit will be 0 to 1. You can observe limit will be 0 to 1. 0 to 1. And y as a function of x. So 1 minus x dx. From the equation of line x plus y equal to 1. Y equal to 1 minus x. Now we integrate this thing. X minus x square by 2, limit 0 to 1, first put upper limit, 1 minus 1 half, minus put lower limit, x equal to 0, 1 half. So total area 4 into alpha, therefore total area equal to 4 into alpha. So 4 into 1 half, that is 2 square unit. For MCQ purpose, directly you can evaluate 1 half base into altitude, 1 half into 1 into 1, 1 half. So for alpha, directly you can give answer. So total area it will be 4 into alpha. Now, second example. Find the area bounded by curve set of all point x comma y, where y greater than or equal to x square and y less than or equal to mod x, y less than or equal to mod x. So if we denote this region by R1 and this region by R2, and that is intersection, so we have to find area of region R1 intersection R2. If we denote this by R, then we have to find area of region R. Now how to find R1 and R2? So y greater than or equal to x square, first it is inequality. Now remove the inequality, take inequality, y equal to x square, that is parabola, square is positive, y is positive, so parabola lies in the first and second quadrant, so it will be of parabola, it will be of this shape. So this is y equal to x square, x axis, y axis. Now we discuss region about y greater than or equal to x square. Here some point 1, 0. Now in this equation put y equal to 0, x equal to 1. So y 0, x 1, this is not true, 0 greater than or equal to 1. So y greater than or equal to x square, y greater than or equal to x square, that is the portion not containing point 1, 0. So for y greater than or equal to x square, inside portion, actually it is not, we can't discuss inside outside because it is not a closed portion. So this is the region for y greater than or equal to x square. Now we discuss second curve, y equal to, we take mod x. So when we remove the modulus, we know y equal to plus minus x, and we know the graph of modulus function, it is union of two rays, so making angle with 45 degree, so maybe slight different due to error in the figure. So y equal to x, y equal to minus x. Now actually it is of this type of shape is there. Now here we consider point 1, 0, y less than or equal to mod x. If we consider, take point 1, 0, 0 less than or equal to 1, so satisfy. So this is R1, pink portion is R1, and R2 is portion which lies below these two rays. So this is the portion R2. Actually, we can't cross y less than or equal to mod x. So below 2 raised. So this is the portion. But we have to think only about this is R2. Green portion is R1. So when we discuss R1 intersection R2, it will be this portion. You can imagine. And bounded portion consists of two equal area because of symmetry. If we denote this by alpha, this by beta, so total area equal to alpha plus beta, and actually 2 times alpha because of symmetry. Now for alpha, easily you can get coordinates of point of intersection here 0, 0, 1, 1. So to evaluate this portion, we will use formula a to b f1x, upper curve is f1x, minus f2x dx. So when we subtract lower portion due to lower curve f2x, we can remove this portion and remaining will give area of intersection of 2. That is, this will be our alpha. So for alpha, a equal to mod I equal to integration a to b f1x minus f2x dx using this formula. Limit will be 0 to 1. F1x, so y equal to f1x, this y equal to f1x, so that is y equal to x, minus y equal to f2x, so this portion is from parabola where y equal to x square, so x minus x square dx. Now this is x square by 2 minus x cube by 3, limit 0 to 1, so 1 half minus 1 by 3, so this will be 1 by 6 square unit, but this is area of alpha, so total area into alpha, so 2 into 1 by 6, that is 1 by 3 square unit. So this is the area of this portion. This is alpha, which we have obtained area for alpha, and because of symmetry this portion, actually it is beta, because of symmetry alpha equal to beta, we have obtained region of alpha, and then we have multiplied it by 2, so total area it is 1 by 3 square unit. Now third example, using the method of intersection. Using the method of integration, find the area of the triangle ABC, coordinates of whose vertices are A2, 0, B4, 5 and C6, solution. Now, first we draw the triangle. This is x-axis, y-axis, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A2, 0. 1 point it is A2, 0. A2, 0. B4, 5. X coordinate 4. Y coordinates 5. So somewhere this is B4, 5. C6, 3. X coordinate 6, Y coordinate 3. So this is the point C6, 3. So now let us join these 3 points, so we will get triangle ABC. So we have to get area of triangle. Now you can easily obtain equation of line AB using the formula determinant xy1 x1 y1 1 x2 y2 1 equal to 0. So using this formula, equation of line AB, it will be y equal to phi by 2 into bracket x minus 2. This is equation of line AB. Easily you can verify. If you take x coordinate 4, 4 minus 2, 2, 2, 2 cancels, so y coordinate 5. Similarly, if you take x coordinate 2, y coordinate will be 0. Equation of line BC. Here, using this formula, you will get y equal to minus x plus 9. And equation of, here also you can verify, take x coordinate minus x equal to 6, so minus 6 plus 9, y coordinate is 3. You take x coordinate 4, so 9 minus 4, y coordinate of B, which is 5. And this is line AC. So equation of line AC, it will be y equal to 3 by 4 x minus 3 by 2. You can verify. You take y coordinate 0. So if you take y coordinate 0, here y 0, then 3 by 4 x equal to 3 by 2. 3, 3 cancel. Easily you can get x coordinate 2. So now we have to find area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC. So to get this area, so area of triangle ABC equal to, now we take foot of perpendicular M 4 comma 0 and 6 comma 0. So area of triangle means first we will find entire this area. So area of A B M A, so equal to area of portion A B M A plus, now second portion, area of B C BC and M. So second portion is this one. So plus area of BC and M and minus. Now we have to subtract this portion. So we have to subtract this portion because only we have to find area of triangle ABC. So minus area of ACNA. Now to find area of ABMA, curve is y equal to phi by 2 into x minus 2. Limit will be 2 to 4. For second area, limit will be 4 to 6 and curve will be y equal to minus x by 9. And to subtract this area, limit will be 2 to 6 and curve will be y equal to 3 by 4 into x minus 3 by 2. So first area of ABMA, it is given by, we are discussing this area. So limit 2 to 4, limit is 2 to 4, 2 to 4, curve is y equal to 5 by 2 into x minus 2, 5 by 2 into x minus 2 dx. So this is area of AB, this is area of ABMA. So we have obtained area of this portion because of this integral. Now for second limit will be 4 to, limit will be 4 to 6. So for second one, now we are discussing area of BC and B. So limit will be 4 to 6. Curve is y equal to minus x by 9. Minus x plus 9 dx. Now to subtract this portion, to remove this area, because of this we have obtained area of, by second integral we have obtained area of this portion. Now when we subtract third one, that means we are subtracting this portion. We are subtracting this portion. So to remove this portion, curve is 3 by 4, y equal to 3 by 4, x minus 3 by 2, and limit will be 2 to 6. So remaining portion is minus limit 2 to 6, 2 to 6, and curve y equal to 3 by 4 into x minus 3 by 2 dx. Now easily you can evaluate this integral. So when you integrate term wise, so first we have obtained area of this portion, because of this integral we have obtained area of this portion ABMA. Because of this we have obtained area of BMCN. B, C, N, M. B, C, N, M. And then we have subtract this portion, which is area of B, C, N, B. So actually alpha plus beta minus gamma, you can consider this one as alpha plus beta minus gamma. For alpha limit is 2,0, here 4,5. So limit is 2 to 4, limit is 2 to 4, and this curve is y equal to 5 by 2 into x minus 2. Now this curve is y equal to minus x plus 9 and limit coordinates of b 4 comma 5 and here c 6 comma 3. So limit is 4 to 6. So limit is 4 to 6. And for this one here, this is a, this is a curve is y equal to 3 by 4 x minus 3 by 2. Here coordinates 2, 0, coordinates of c it is 6, 3. So limit is, you can observe, limit is 2 to 6. So 2 to 6. So total area alpha plus beta minus gamma, and when you evaluate this integral, answer will be, your answer will be 7 square unit. Your answer will be 7 square unit. So using integration we have obtained required area. Now term wise you can integrate this, evaluate alpha, you can also evaluate alpha, beta, gamma separately, and then you can find area by alpha plus beta minus gamma. Independently I have shown portion alpha, beta, gamma, so easily you can integrate it, and total answer it will be 7 square unit will be answer.